Hey everybody, and welcome back to the live stream. Welcome back, as in because you're here on Friday and we were having such a lovely time. Did you have a nice long weekend? As long and nice as I did. It was lovely. Sorry that I wasn't around on Saturday or Monday as well. I hope you guys did all right without me. How are you doing? What did you get up to? Hello everybody in the chat. Good to see you all here, nice and early. At the start of the week, it is good to see people arriving here on Tuesday. Dante 2050, Orange Spark, Grief Tigerius, Andrea Kitty here, Percat 259, Orange Spark, Black Sheep Kitty, Academic Dust, Shan, all the guys are here. Everyone's here. Assistant producer Coots, of course, is here. Assistant to the producer, of course. But yeah, how is everybody? What you all been doing? There's been a lot going on. Somebody asked me earlier on, we're going to get jumping straight away here, by the way, this week, because We're so far behind. Now that we've got Shan in the chat, this cable has gone really, it's really putting me off. I have to make sure I feel like I'm drawing in a boat. Well, we're off to a good start. So a lot of people over the weekend asked me if I watched the new Top Gear. Did everyone watch the new Top Gear? What did everyone think of the new Top Gear? I'm going to go in Shan's group as well, so then he can see me and help me out on my journey. I just choked on a peach. Oh dear, that's not good at all. Don't do that again. But yeah, what's the new Top Gear? What did everyone think of the new Top Gear? It's a very hot topic, of course, amongst us Brits. We really care about that because apparently it was some sort of... what would you call it? What's the word? A British institution, you know, and apparently we were really, there was a lot of people who were getting quite upset about how it's changed and how it's not the same, it's not what it used to be. I don't know, what did everybody think? One second, I'm just trying to work out, I'm trying to get things back on, you know, it's a new week, you've got to get everything set up again. But basically, it was trying too hard, says Robbie XP1. So for me, what I saw is an attention-seeking, very English person running around, being over the top and enthusiastic. And I thought, who would be like that, hey? Who would be an over the top enthusiastic British person? Wow! Laughing and joking. Who wants anyone like that? I thought, no, I can't relate to him at all. I could replace Chris Evans. Now we're talking. That is what we need to do. We need to get me to replace Chris Evans. What I found about it is, and I was watching it just for a short amount of time, is that actually I thought it was very difficult for them to do. Like what a really tough job they had, because they had to follow up something that people absolutely loved. And how difficult, that's so difficult. Oh look, I did a temporary bookmark the wrong way. That's good, isn't it? I'm glad I did that. Friday was a strange day, wasn't it? Friday was a great day, with the return of Walter Neil Lewis for the Bisquiz. All right, Shan, have you seen how quickly you can plot things now? Watch this, going all the way over this way. Look how dense it is over here, by the way. Check this out. Boom. Not even a few seconds, let's get jumping. Let's get going. Let's get going, everybody. Over the Top Gear, yeah. I love Matt. If they had the Queen and England Top Gear, then there would still have been a backlash. Exactly right, Robbie XP1. They had such a tough challenge ahead of them to make sure they could do that. Biscuit reviews and a reasonably priced car. Yeah, we can get that done. Over the Top Gear. Yeah, over the Top Gear. I like that. Very good. I couldn't stand the last three very much either. And I know that's going to be a very... potentially... What's the word? Guy, what's happened? It feels like the weekend has zapped me of all of my... Let's be honest. I've never had any skills or any, you know... Biscuit dunking in 40 minutes. Thanks, Griefed. Thanks for ending this mess of an introduction. This is still the introduction, everyone. We're still being introduced, of course. This is the Biscuit Review live stream, or the Journey Home, as it was previously called, previously known as the Journey Home Review, where I jump all the way home back to Solve, all the way from Beagle Point, which I made legitimately on my own proper account. And don't let me tell you folks at home that I'm quite glad that I'm currently not in the bubble. I have to say, from what I hear, the AI has received a somewhat ambitious boost in its behaviour. Of course, if you are interested in that, we do have, I think, a post going out later today from us in the community team about what we're doing to sort of make sure that people stay happy with that sort of thing. So we're not here to discuss the AI changes specifically here today, but I do want to tell you that if I was in the bubble with all this data, I would be very nervous right now. That's all I'm saying. Andrea. Hello, Andrea. Good to see you. Who would be Ed Stig? That would be Michael Brooks, but I'm sure his beard would spill out from the the helmet that he's trying to wear, and you would see it approaching out there. He could just turn his beard into a helmet, just wrap it around his head. Yeah. All right, here we go. 10. Let's see if there's another potential Ed's 38. Orange Spark, there's no live stream tonight, but there is one tomorrow night. So tomorrow night we'll be talking about the dangerous games. Just talking about danger, stranger danger. Stay away from strangers. They're very dangerous. Stay away from them. So this has already been discovered. We don't want none of this. And all that second-hand nonsense. Oh, and of course, a quarter to the hour, so in about 38 minutes time. And I'm hopefully Griefed will be keeping us up to date, or iGamer17, depending on who is here to do that. We have the Biscuit review, of course, at quarter two as well. Oh, we've just had word from the chat that iGamer17 has arrived and he's going to take over with the downtime, with the countdown. The official count of down. I love it. Yeah, I am feeling a shambling, rambling intro. I am feeling a little shambling and rambling today, so I hope you don't mind that. Oh, you haven't. It's unscoopable. If the next one is an unscoopable, then it's time to start worrying. I'm sure it won't be. Hey, Paterisk, how are you? Good to see you here. Dr. Noesis, good to see you here too. Good to see all the regulars here, including Griefed and Orange Spark. Even those guys. I hope you're excited about today's biscuit. I know I am. I mean, how couldn't you be? I'm going to move me over a little bit over this way. There you go. I think I might be coming down with a cold. Everybody, I think I might. Coates, I think we need someone to fill in for me. I'm coming down with a cold. Coates, who would you want to put in my place? Is Chris Evans available? Let me know if Chris Evans is available to fill in. It'd be really great. I have enough tea to last for a week, Dante 2050. Yes, I do. I have 660 tea bags. I haven't opened them yet because we have them at work and work provide tea bags. So I'm just sort of sitting on these 660 tea bags like, I don't know what to do with these. I might just take them home and just have it as my supply at home for the rest of my life. I wonder how long 660 tea bags can last. Where are we now? Yeah. So, I'm coming down with an occult. I'm coming down in the occult. Yes, that is happening too. You want Sandro here instead of me. Oh, is my replacement for when I've got a cold. All hands to the battle station, special man flu incoming. Brace your Kleenex for impact, says Dr. Noesis. Yeah, I just sort of feeling a little groggy, I think is the word. The review will begin in 35 minutes, coming from deep space. Thank you very much, iGamer. You are the official countdown for one reason, and that is you perform your job admirably, sir. Admirably, sir! So I didn't tweet about I didn't tweet about today's stream. I thought I would give it a little test and see what happens if I don't tweet about it. And it looks like we do have fewer viewers, but I reckon that'll pick up throughout the week. I think it's one of those things. It's Tuesday. When you're away, I'm learning so much about being a streamer, right? What I did was I played a video game called YouTuber Life, and there I learned everything there is to know about being a YouTuber. I didn't really play YouTuber Life, and I have to say, I'm a bit
puzzled as to what it is and why it is and why people are playing it, really, I have to say.
You've done a bug report. I noticed a lot of systems I've been now requires an unknown permit, says Corpse Necromus. Are you sure that that is a bug? I don't know. I actually don't know myself. Are these systems that you've previously been to? It's a good question. It's a fine question, sir. Twitch notifications for the win. 0x666C69743. Is there an easier way, 0x666C69743, to pronounce your name, sir? Because I always feel like I want to say it nice and quickly, but then, or madam, I do apologise if I've offended you. Hey, shiny hair person. Hey, futuristic F. How are you? What are you up to? You're new to the streams. Everybody, say hello to futuristic F and tell them one thing about the stream that they might not know. Ox, says Commander Coots. Great. I don't know what you're talking about. There's a wall preventing you from going in. Is this somewhere that you've previously been? Like I said, then it's usually fine. Are you sure that everybody else is not experiencing this? It's not something I know about. All I need to do is get my him, her, hex. Oh, hex. Hex, is that right? Hex, like just an anonymous gender. Ed does biscuit science. So the most important thing about this stream, of course, is that at 1:45, that's when you'll start to see that the chat expands a little bit and more people arrive. Because people don't care about this bit. People here, the real people, the originals are here right now and watch me from the beginning. But the sort of the hanger-oners, they come at the end during the last quarter of an hour to watch the biscuit review. We've currently, this is today, is everyone, we're reaching a milestone today. It is our 30th biscuit today. We'll be reviewing our 30th biscuit at about 1:45. And let me tell you, let me do a little wink, a little winky face to you all about what the biscuit will be. But it... 30 reviews, well, that calls for a party, wink, wink, a party, yeah, there's only one type of biscuit that you need to serve at a party. Also, spoiler, I hate them, so this is going to be fun, isn't it? Futuristic Kung Fu from the forums, futuristic Kung Fu from the forums, futuristic Kung Fu, hey futuristic Kung Fu, I will remember that as best I possibly can. Base 16, I'm very confused. like if your future content says KVLRG, most probably that, yes. Commander Coots might be onto something. All decent programmers can think in hex. Okay, Andrea, you've outed me. I have never done any programming in my life. Dante 2050, does said biscuit have a hole in the middle? Maybe it does, maybe. Adding to the fun, of course, that you have. In what way? What is happening there? I've never seen anything like that before. Nothing special. What a huge shame. We're making tracks here. Shan, is Shan in the chat? If Shan could please... can you plot to... Yes, thank you. I was literally saying, like, Shan, can you help me out? And then you did straight away, even before I asked. Chief Navigator Shan there helping me out, make all the way home. If you are here for the first time, welcome. Thank you very much for joining us. This is a live stream where I am going all the way to Sol from Beagle Point, and I thought I would stream it on my way because I'm going to be playing at my lunchtime anyway. It's my lunchtime break right here, right now. iGamer17 says, is it a party ring? Oh, well, you'll have to find out. You'll find out in 30 minutes. If you look at your left side of cabin, you will see stars and space dust. That is, that is very accurate, as you can see. Well, you can't really see any stars right now because the brightness of this star is right in my face. Wait for it. Oh, there's one. Spotted one. I win. Where am I going, sorry? Where am I going, Sham? Here we go, all the way over here. route unavailable because I am miles away from it. But I am heading in that general direction, sort of. I'm heading sort of sideways. Is that okay? Excuse me. Shan, is that all right? I'm going that way anyway. I'm carrying on. I'm pushing through. We're making it. We're doing good. We're doing good work here. Doing good work. Did 0x666C697473 ever explain how we're supposed to pronounce your name? I have an instruction on pronunciation, but I don't use it for my own amusement. Have you told me about the pronunciation? As long as it's not towards your ships, it's good. Yeah. I think it is. Oh, Ed Lewis is awesome, says Futuristic Kung Fu. See, I remembered your name as well. Well, you win extra stream points, which don't exist. But if I did have a system implemented whereby I could give stream points to people, Coots, write that one down, then I would give you extra stream points for saying that I'm awesome. It's very, very kind of you. This stream, of course, if you are just seeing it for the first time, is just nonsense. Oh, you did tell me. You did tell me by its decimal number. I remember that now. But I can't remember. We split this personal custom 8-bit values, which then translate to Unicode characters. Well? I remember from the very first beta livestream you told me, and I just... Flitz? Is that what it is? I can't remember what it was. Yeah, Futuristic Kung Fu. Yeah, you write down that I gave you some extra stream points. The answer was you're screwed for being around Beagle Point. I'm really hoping... Ankbot is all I need, is that right? What is Ankbot? Should I download Ankbot, everybody? What does everybody think? Obi-Wan Kenobi's here, everyone. So, hold the phone. Everybody stop. Everyone stop for 1 second. Just round of applause for Obi-Wan Kenobi for turning up. He's late. That's making him feel uncomfortable about turning up late. Like when you walk into sort of a room late and you just like everyone, like a meeting and everyone's already sitting down, or like a lecture. Do you remember lectures? They were fun, weren't they? This is kind of like a lecture. It's about as entertaining as a lecture is anyway. And you learn nothing from it, which is very, very similar to my experience at university was like. FSD malfunctions, everybody. Andy FM, are you there? I've heard that Andy FM is having to be a little bit careful with his bar duties today. So if Andy FM's not there, can somebody else please man the bar? That's two FSD malfunctions in a row. We are desperate, everybody. Everyone knows what happens, basically. We all have a pretend shot, and everybody drinks very, very carefully and considerately for one another. So that's two. Andy FM, please. We need some drinks. Hello, Hatch. Lectures plus biscuits, that's correct. There's lots of interesting chat happening here. Stop, collaborate, and listen. Yes, and thought it's one of the most robust popular Twitch chat spots. Thank you, Perkactive59. You once got chucked out of a lecture for drinking a can of Coke. It might explain your poor education. No comments on that, Coots. I've seen your CV. You sent it to me to apply for this very job. Didn't really, it's not a real job. Oh, Paul Archer's jumped over the bar. Thank you, Paul Archer. You're dishing out Twackers? I don't think I'm not familiar with those. What are those? If somebody could help me out there, that'd be lovely. What's the idea? You love that idea. Oh, yeah, Perkout259, you can explain hexadecimal numbers to me at LaveCon anytime, or maybe on the one day that it is actually on. Can't remember the date. Hey, Saffron, how are you? Good to see you. I'm hoping there is a way home so I don't run into a wall. Me too. 25 minutes, and iGamer17 is running out of snappy things to say. iGamer17, believe me, I'm in the same boat as you now. We're now, this is our 30th stream of doing this. 30 streams, 30 hours of jumping, and I've made about 5,000 light years. So as you can see, progress is slow, But it's all going to be worth. It's all worth it in the end. Look at this lovely collection of people we've built up here. Oh, this chat is so wonderful and so lovely. I genuinely look forward to it every single day. Hope you all know that is a sincere moment from me. From me to you, sincere moment right now. Sincere face on. Thank you very much for being here. And every single day, a lot of you come along. And I really do, really, really, really enjoy it because it actually keeps me going in a lot of ways because I know that you lot want, will be here just to chat and just be silly and fun and have fun. And I really hope you appreciate it too, because it does allow me to do these things where I would usually have to be very serious and very, hello everybody, welcome to the official Elite Dangerous live stream, and be on message and you know, you're representing a company, it's quite difficult stuff. So when I get to do these, I get to just be myself entirely. And then for some reason, you, the original 38, just keep coming back time and time again. So genuinely, I want to keep doing these, even if it does take me another 70 episodes, 100 episodes, we're going to still keep doing them, and I hope that you will be there the entire time. Thank you very much. Yeah. I have too much fun on the official live stream. I have been told that before by, I do have, yeah, I should be very, I actually slept on the chat as well on official streams. Where else can I be? Yeah, a complete, yeah, that's right. Over here, you can be an idiot as well with me. FOD4U2 says, love the 1.6 update for Xbox, but think it might have killed PowerPlay. Oh, that's an interesting piece of feedback. Hope that you've left it somewhere on the forums or let us know somewhere else, because that's an interesting point that needs expressing to the developers. Yeah, imagine when I get back, I can upgrade my Asp Explorer. Upgrade to the Asp Explorer. I'm currently in an Asp Scout. So it's going to be a massive upgrade for me. It's going to be amazing. Genuinely can't wait to get back to see what I can do. Three jumps, then I'll have done 286 light years today. Of course, we've got another 25 minutes until the biscuit review, or however many it is. I'm sure that it says here 25 minutes. Yeah. Commander Coots has never played Power Play. No, some people have chosen never to play it, which I think is quite interesting. Hello, Captain Fluffy. Yes, hello, tomorrow you'll be working for me and actually be able to watch. Great stuff, I'll also promote it as well tomorrow, which I didn't do today, so then people have a link on their Twitter or things like that. Yeah, I did, we got absolutely destroyed on the official live stream after 7.5 hours the other week. And Adam Woods was in here, was playing. And then who was it? Was it Dana Jessica Booth who actually took Adam out? I thought that was amazing. 6 minutes of power play, that's a very specific amount of time. You love the new challenging NPCs. This is the problem. This is the sort of problem of sorts, is that some people are saying, I love the new challenging AI, but then it's a big balance that I'm sure that the developers, well, I know that they're all hands on deck today working on. And they're going to do their best to, iron things out and find that right balance right down the middle. And again, this stream is definitely not the time or the place. It's definitely not the time nor the place for this kind of chat. I am tired though. What's going on? I got rained on this morning, everybody. Rained. It was disgusting. It was like a tsunami. What I imagine is a tsunami, but like a Cambridge one. It's like a Cambridge-style tsunami, so it was very polite and well-educated and very, very middle-class indeed. So it asked before very, very nicely if it was going to, if it was okay if it was to rain. But then I cycled here in jogging bottoms because I thought that would be a sensible thing to do. And of course, jogging bottoms just so happened to be the most absorbent material, be made of the most absorbent materials, instead of what I was hoping would happen is that it would sort of, I don't know, it'll soak into that first, and then that way it wouldn't get my legs cold and wet, and then I could change into my jeans when I got here. But what I didn't think of is how heavy the rain would be, and of course soaked my bag entirely too. So I was soaked through to the core, or literally my core, from here down, because I was wearing a helmet. And even that didn't do much job of keeping out the rain. And so I was just basically a sopping wet rat by the time I arrived at work today. Yeah, so there you go. ED, Lewis is awesome. Oh, I see what you're doing there. I see the play on words that you're doing there. You didn't have to go. You have to go and do tidying type things. The background noise there. Whilst everyone, I'll be back at screen for Biscuit time. Great Ales Griff 79. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you very much for being here. Hey Lewis, drying the roads of Cambridge with one pair of jogging bottoms. That's it. That is the task that I have been given. Shan, did you have a plot somewhere I can jump to? It's just that I'm. Oh no. Okay, I'm there. Somewhere to plot to, Shan. Why has it gone that way now? I want to delete that bookmark. Silly. Delete it. Good. Yes, I did lose the plot a long time ago. One moment, says Shan. Thank you very much, Shan. You're a champ. We're quite far away now from Ed's 38. That's pretty cool. We're making some ground here, I feel. I might be wrong. I don't think the ice cream van will turn up today either, everybody. Sorry to let you down. Ice cream van is not occurring. Oh. Route plotting failed. That's new. Try Cho Tier GFRD41. Thank you very much, Shan. You are an absolute life saver. A saver of lives. No, says Show Thea. It says, no, you cannot get there. But you think I should head towards that? That's kind of almost in a different direction to where I'm going. But we can give it a go. Route plotting failed even this close in. It's nice and thick down here. I mean, this is where I am right now. And then I'm trying to get all the way over there. But apparently, there may be now some roadblocks in the way as well, which I find fun. Anything else? Any other hot tips, guys? I'm just going to sort of head back this way towards where it looks really busy over up here. Like this way. Look over here. This looks nice. Oh. Oh, gosh. Adding as a bookmark and add to it. All right. This is where we're trying to get to. light years away. Bookmark! And then edit. And then go here. Please. I always have to, I like to make sure that I'm as polite and courteous as possible to even myself, even though that's the Ronkono Crossing. Great. All right. So we know where that is now. Over there. That's the other. Wait. No. Sorry. That one over here. All right. So do I need to? Does that mean I need to go left further first? I think it does. I think it really does. So that's over there. That's there. I think we head this way first. Am I mad for thinking that? Ugh. Yeah, this is good. We're in a good space here. It's a good time. I don't know. I mean, what do you guys, what does everyone think? Am I in the 65,000 light year club? Yes, I am, Saffron. I got all the way to Beagle Point myself, and this is us trying to get back. But as you can see, I'm a little bit of a pickle. What feels to me like it is a pickle. Let's just try and move here and see what that gives me. And then, I don't know, that looks like I can't then jump to... Oh, I can. All right, let's take it nice and easy. Let's take it nice and easy. Route plan failed, ouch. Oh, hello. That's bizarre, isn't it? Let's just go there. Let's see what that looks like. 15 minutes, 14 jumps. We can do that. Jump a minute. Let's go. Let's go, 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 go! So everybody, what we're going to do by the end of this week is that I'm going to have made it all the way back to Seoul by the end of this week. So that means that I'm going to play for 60 hours straight tomorrow. By the way, this isn't happening. I'm just saying it as a joke because, wow, that would be a lot of effort and time. And I have a job to do, of course, which you all know because you watch me do it regularly, which is very, very nice of you. Yes, I am mad. Call the fuel rats. It's not the fuel rats that I need. It is not the fuel rats that I need. You just retrace your steps, surely, obviously. Yeah, sure. I found a place to get to. When fighting early FDLs, yeah, that is tough. Don't worry about that. You keep fighting your FDLs, Shan, and I'll fight my own battles out here. But yeah, I really do. This does extra mean, apparently, because the AI is really good now. It would only take 16 hours. Not at this rate. You've seen how slowly I'm going here. This might be your first time at Futuristic Kung Fu. Might be your first time here on the stream. But I'm a slow mover. I'm a slow mover indeed. I like to take things nice and easy so then I can get lots of biscuit reviews in. Today's biscuit is very disappointing. I'm already disappointed. And I haven't even begun to... I haven't even eaten it yet. I can just tell. I'm just looking at it. You know what else happened as well? And you lot will be furious about this. Came into work, soaked through like a rat, thinking, oh, what will be great is when I can sit down with my Yorkshire tea mug and have a lovely, relaxing cup of tea. Guess what? Somebody else in the office had commandeered my Yorkshire tea mug. That's the only proof I've got, is that it was not in the cupboard and it was not in the dishwasher. So the only answer is that somebody from the development team is using my Yorkshire tea mug without my permission. I must add, without my permission indeed. So what's everyone doing? 15 minutes confirmed Ed has space madness. Yes, I do. Yes, yes, yes. I've had that a long time ago. A long time ago. I want names, Ed. I don't know. I'm really, really sorry. I don't know. What's the name of the city I'm going to? I don't think that there's going to be any permit walls right by where I am right now. I'm too far out, surely. I'll be able to work my way around it. It is. It will not stand at all. Get the pitchforks, everybody. Come on. Get the back. Hunt them down, Torps. Wait, all right, yes. Get... How dare they, says Obi-Wan Kenobi. Might possibly contain edible biscuit-like materials from Dante 2050. I haven't received a package today. When did you send it? Orange Spark, that's a lovely pitchfork, as is Saffron's. I'm not sure which one I like. Orange Spark's like a double-handed one, or like a thicker pitchfork. Oh, using the Euro symbol there to great... effect. Very much enjoy the Euro symboled pitchfork. Try this one. You'd like to know just so I can warn you. Alright, have a look on the screen here, Corps. You can see there. That's where I'm heading to now. Oh! Sorry, I'm just far too efficient with my time. The Euro pitchfork TM. And it's, what's good about the Euro pitchfork is that it is kind of relevant to... you sent a package last week. I've not received one. Which is a shame. Because, yeah, Dr. Noesis, oh God, lots of nothing's turning up. And people, I think people have caught wind of what you're sending me. And so then the receptionist, what she's doing, she's grabbing them before they arrive. I mean, this is all I can assume. She's probably got my Yorkshire tea mug as well. Coates, Detective Coates, you're now a detective. Who wants to be chief detective in this matter? I've nominated myself. I will be chief detective in this matter. It looks as if we have one... we have one major suspect, and it is Harry, our receptionist. So after this, I'm going to go down and have some serious words. First of all, we'll find me like a Detective Trilby and like a detective suit, and then I will just go around asking sort of leading questions. Very good at leading questions. Yeah, the Euro Pitchfork, of course, is for when you need to make a mob in a hurry. Yes, very good. They're very good at that. It's also quite relevant to what we're doing at the moment in terms of with Brexit and leaving the Euro versus not leaving the Euro. And I wonder if the Euro Pitchfork can in any way assist with those who do want us to leave. I'm on the fence myself. Very... very not politically minded at all. I sit right down the middle. I play video games, and then I go, "Meh." On the when it comes around to voting, I go, "Yeah, all right, I'll tick a box." Because if one does not vote, and we don't do politics on this show, because one, we don't know anything about it, and two, that's not what today is about. It's about eating biscuits and playing Elite Dangerous. That's what it's about. Sorry, corpse. Ed Lewis, who is Morse? No, if Ed is Lewis, yes, because Detective Lewis in Lewis and Morse. Coots, you can be Morse, I'm assuming. Or Zach. Zach, I can actually make a good Morse. Did it go to the Professor of Galactic Biscuitology? Is that literally what you wrote down on the name? Because, yeah, that could be to anyone. I haven't received anything to the Professor of Biscuitology. The joys of life. The joys of life, says futuristic Kung Fu. What are you saying? The only thing that I'm... you're wrong, Ed. We know fracking is wrong because Dad Lewis told us he did. If there's one thing that he wanted to get across, it is that fracking is bad. He doesn't care. He's got an agenda, that guy. He seems fun. He seems like he's coming on to have fun with us and do a quiz, but really, he's an anti-fracking campaigner planted within my streams to slowly bend you to his will. Galactic Biscuitology. That's great. Yes, Orange Spark. Make it so. Make it so. Tell Zach that I sent you. He won't mind. Sorry, I don't know which one I'm going to. Do you need me to stop? Corpse. Sorry, there's a lot of face rubbing. I've noticed, I watched back a little bit of the stream. I do this a lot. Just grab my face and just rub it. Just do it. Everyone do it right now. Just really quick. Feels really good. But then it also picks up on the microphone as well, like this sort of, like a, you can hear the dryness of my skin. Here's another thing, everybody, moisturise. That's another top tip, Ed's top life tips, moisturise. One, moisturise. Two, biscuits. Done. Three, live. Joy. Nothing else. Drink water. Sleep. Get some sleep. Sit-ups. 10 a day. Max. That's all you should do. 10 sit-ups, what a day. That is how you get looking as good as Jon Snow himself. That is Jon Snow, the newsreader, not Jon Snow from the popular show Game of Thrones, Game of Andor Thrones. Andy FM, please pour us a shot. I know he's not around, but if you can pour us a shot, you always three drinks, Andy FM. Three drinks now. Paul Archer has just been asked why he's wearing his face and is everything okay. I love it. 10 seconds, sorry, left panel. It's too late now. 5 minutes. The parking spot is being cleaned for my arrival. Thank you very much. iGamer17. Although, can I say, by the way, Yes, yes, Coots. If you could get Oil of Olay onto the line for me, that would be very, very good. And don't make sure they don't include any of those. Also, no palm oil. Don't want any of that. Environmentally friendly and all that. Also, make sure they don't have any of those plastic balls in there because they're really bad for the environment. They're good for your face because they're clean in the pores, but they're bad for the environment. Everyone should look after this wonderful Earth of ours. Otherwise, we'll all have to get into spaceships and do this for real. And no one actually really wants that. Everyone thinks they want that, but no one wants to be doing this for real. Thank you, Shan. You are lovely. Left panel now. Shan, there you go. That's where I am. The straitjacket's arriving for Archer. Good. I hope that you explained. Oh, just some guy on the internet told me to rub my face, so I'm rubbing it. I think that they would completely understand that at that point. So if this is your first time on the live stream, first of all, let me apologise to you for this. It's a bit insane. I'm sorry. But we are coming up in 5 minutes to the biscuit review, and that is some good solid content right there. So do stick around for that. We're at biscuit review 30, and it calls for a party, if you know what I mean. It's a pink party as well. Pink themed. Don't know why. Eco Ed, yeah. Use planet oils, they're the best. So let's see if I've got 4 jumps to go. I've done pretty good jumping. Pretty good jumping today. We've done over 40 jumps. No, is that right? Does anyone see 40 jumps? No, that can't be right. Maybe around about 40 jumps. 14 jumps in the last 40 minutes. Yeah, over 40 jumps. Hannock Spankers says, the water from Earth has no isotopes from comets. Biological activity created the water over billions of years. Fracking will dissolve the USA and eventually be able to sell to China westways, as the myth predicted. Welcome, Hankers Pankers, to the stream. If this is your first time here, you're in good company, believe me. Hello. Especially with comments like that, which mind-blowing conspiracies that I think are definite truths. 100% true comment from Hankers Pankers. Also, I love the name Hankers Pankers. It's very fun to say, so I'm gonna say it one more time. Hankers Pankers. Yay! So, in a few minutes' time, less than 5 minutes, we will be approaching my destination, wherever that is, slightly closer to Sol from Beagle Point. How many miles do you think we are? And I want it in miles, please, not light years. So if you can all convert one light year to how many miles there are in a light year, that's probably a lot. And then times that by how many light years you think I'm away, and then we'll have a figure of how many miles away I am from Seoul. What does everybody think about that? Coots, I'm out because I didn't say you're out. Dr. Noesis, when did I chuck... What? Did I chuck... Have I got to fire someone? Oh. You... Oh, because of the thing, the rubbing in the face, we were... Yes, thanks, Coots. Playing a game of Simon Says there. But very smartly, because it is my stream and not I'm not called Simon, he changed the name of it to Ed Says instead, which I think was a very smart choice, very logical. Yeah, so I might do a little tweet now and see if we can bring in some more people for the biscuit reviews in just a few minutes' time. Apparently 1 minute time. Somewhere between 1 and infinity minus 1. Yes. To infinity minus 1 equals infinity. Come on, guys. We all know the nature of infinity. I am very confused. Oh, you guys playing with your big space numbers. What are you like, eh? I really do need to get home though at some point. As in, like, back to Seoul. Like, this. As much as we're all having fun out here, taking our time, delaying my arrival by doing silly games like quizzes and guest Wednesdays and biscuit reviews, at some point I am going to have to make it home, aren't I? This These ideas are why you pay me literally nothing to produce the show. That's exactly right, yeah. I literally, and I'm not, that's not even an exaggeration. I literally pay him nothing, and he produces his entire show. He's lucky that it takes literally no production time. But producer Coots is a good, he's a good chap. He's a good boy. And he works wonders. Magic. Could it be? Could it be? No, it cannot be. It is definitely not. All right, let's scoop up all of this lovely tasting fuel. Petrol-y. Let's see what happens. Look at the top right corner. There's a button on the right panel which takes you home within 30 seconds. Really? I know what button you're referring to, and I'm not going to go for it. Where is it? Top right corner. Where's my? There must be suicide button. Like actually, you can see it in the game. It'd be fun if you could. If you could sort of deploy your SRV mid space. I'm going to catch it. Okay, just checked a moment ago, the distance you have to the nearest permanent wall is so far that it's likely fixed if it is a thing that needs fixing. I don't know. Okay, so everybody, you know how this works. It's quarter two. It's the first Biscuit stream of the week. It's the first Biscuit review of the week. We've got a special one because we're at 30. And every 10, 30 just feels like a big number to me. I mean, read. The review will begin now, so pay up and display, and for the cleaning service you'll be charged 500,000 credits. I will get that to you later. Can I do you an IOU iGamer17, please? That would be really, really handy. All right, so to the back soon screen. And yeah, we'll be back. I'm going to pop off to make a brew. And I will be back in about 3 minutes with a fresh brew to do today's Biscuit review. See you in a sec. Thank you. Sorry about change. Sorry about the changes there. I just trying something new out, you know? I thought I would just try something new. Just for one day. Just for one day. It was a music version of the Mario theme. Cheers. Oh, nothing quite like a good cuppa. So let's get the biscuit spreadsheet up. Bam! That's what it looks like. So as you can see, everybody, it's a very, very exciting day indeed. The Tesco Rich Tea Finger is at the bottom of the spreadsheet, while as the Fox's Chunky Cookie is right there at the top, still taking the lead, right there up at the top, looking great, with Crunch Cold and Cream second place. Third place, Milk Chocolate Covered Hobnob. The Oreo Double Stuff, Oreo Chocolate Cream, the Maryland Cookie, the Tim Tam up there in eighth place. Very, very, very good.
Surprising.
Oreo Original, the Fox's Jam and Cream, Raspberry and Vanilla. But can today's biscuit, of course, because it is the 30th, that means that it is a celebration. It's the 30th. This is where the magic happens right now. Thank you, Shan, again, for the mug. Gotta thank Shan. It's just been recently washed. Its first wash. You can see that it's changed colour slightly. It's slightly more clean now, previously unwashed. All right, so today's biscuit. Spoilers, I hate today's biscuit. Let's see how it does on the spreadsheet on the 7-point scale, which is appearance, taste, texture, durability, dunkability, post-taste, satisfaction, more chance in total. By the way, can everybody send some real positive vibes right now? Sorry, it's face rubbing again. It's face rubbing time. Want to send some real positive vibes to internet vibes. Like, everybody, like, pretend we're sending an aura ball. Fill it with positivity and good luck. Send it to Lindsay. You might have heard of Lindsay. She's my girlfriend. She's very, very lovely. She's doing currently an exam, which is very, 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 very important for her. It's to do with a second master's degree. She's got to do that before she can do a PhD. It's very, very important to her. So please send some positive. She's literally in the exam right now, working really, really hard. So send that her way, and that'll be really, really nice. Thank you. Cheers. All right. I must just need more caffeine. That's what happened at the start of this live stream. So today, it is a party. What else do you need to take at parties? Of course, the party ring. It's a party in a biscuit. You can wear it over your eye. Like this, kid. And yeah, you can see me through it, like that. You can, hello, I'm the party ring. So thank you very much for saying good luck. It's very, very kind of you. Very, very lovely. I'll let her know later on when I show her this video and show all your lovely chatting. Yeah, yuck, right? Someone's got to do this for science. Party rings. Natural colours. It has to specify that because it's derived from fruit and vegetable. Honestly, it's not a weird... It's just because it tastes weird and sugary doesn't mean that it is bad for you. Fox's party ring. Every day's a party. Every day's a party. Every day, including today, is a party. Is tomorrow a party? I'm going to a funeral at the weekend. Is that a party? Every day. All you have to do is serve Fox's party rings and it will be a party. Suitable vegetarians. And it's got Vinny's quality guarantee. A large part of his job is making biscuits. It's tasting biscuits, so I can personally guarantee that these biscuits are not just delicious, but they have more yum per crumb in every bite. Got something to say on the matter? Contact me at talktovinny@foxesbiscuits.co.uk, or you can find him at Fox's Biscuits on Twitter as well. Yeah, it's a party. I will cry if I want to. Vinny dinged you on Twitter. What do you mean he dinged you? Dinged? Natural colours. Honestly, natural colours. Pink one, this one. Right, okay, let's get straight into it. We're calling it the Fox's Party Rings, in case there are any future party rings that come by. But they are sort of the official party rings, as far as party rings go. Appearance. Here's the one thing I think about... ignored. Okay, dinged. The one thing I think about party rings is its fun appearance. They look so much nicer than they're going to taste. Look at that lovely little crossing on the back, the way that the biscuit crosses over. And then it's like got that nice bright colours, and they've got like the stripes on them, you know? Like the lovely little swirly stripes. They look like a nice cake. So appearance is actually quite high. It's not amazing, it's a 7. Let's go for taste. Let's see how this bad boy tastes. And also, I have to do it in small amounts because this literally was the last one I stole from downstairs. That's a disappointing taste, that. It almost tastes of nothing. I hate that biscuit. It's almost of nothing. It's the sugariness of the ring as well. Why? It deserves a bonus point for the novelty, which it did. It got to 7. But what novelty? Like, in what way is this? Why did they market it as party rings? Any of the other biscuits on this list? Any. A really bad office party. That's right, says Titus Balls. Really bad office party. Texture, mouthfeel, it's just rubbish. It's 3.8. Durability. It snapped in half when I put it in my mouth, but there are very few crumbs, so that makes up for it up there in the sixes. Dunkability. Here we go. Let's see how this lasts. It might be amazing. It might be amazing at the dunkability. Everyone knows how to do it. Someone tell Ed how to freeze the top line. Yeah. Can somebody literally tell me, this is the free version, this is open office version. Someone tells me how to freeze the top line, that'd be very, very helpful. So then everybody else can see where I'm up to. And also it'll aid me in my scientific endeavours. Are you ready? Oh, I got this horrible sugary. It says sugary. It tastes like a sugary sweet. Rubbish. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Pull out. It looks okay. You're getting some warping around the top, but you're not losing any of the structure. It's very, very solid, but 1, 2, 3. It's, but let me tell you though, you can hear that tinking away. But let me tell you, that is only because it's so such a hard snapping biscuit anyway. Oh. It's slightly better. Oh, this is horrible. The icing is like scraping on my teeth as well, so you get that sort of. And does anyone in the chat want to stick up for the bite ring right now? I don't know if they are or not. They don't seem marketed after kids. Maybe they do. Somebody please stick up for the pie ring. I feel bad for the pie ring right now. Nope. No, says Academic Just 894. Titus Ball says no. No, sack the pie ring. No. I've never seen you like this before. This is the worst biscuit, says Saffron. Exactly. No, nope. No. Come on, there's got to be one person. Last time I had one, I think it was 5. No, I hate them, says Commander Hatch. No. And yet they still sell them in, like, premium-looking packaging. Who are they for? Who's this? I'm so sorry to be. You know me, I like to remain positive as much as I possibly can, but the party ring, it ain't no party in my mouth, that's for sure. Dunkability, it did very, very well on the dunkability, but I don't want to give it too much credit. Post-dunk taste, it was slightly better than it was before, so it's a 4.1. Satisfaction. I hate the party ring. Oh, that's a brutal score. Almost bad doing it. 36.9. It's higher than the Tesco Rich D Finger, though, which is very shocking indeed. Because I don't hate the Rich D Finger. It just wasn't very good. But I have to say, it's probably the dunkability, isn't it? It's probably the dunkability that's pushed it up to 8. Yeah, because the dunkability of the Tesco Rich D Finger was 1. Wow, there you go. 35. What are they for? What are they for? 37.9. Well, at least we've got a good cup of Yorkshire tea. That makes up for us. It's the boss to buy. I'm literally going to take this downstairs to our purchasing person who buys the daily biscuits for us and be like, here's a list. Here's what you need to buy. Just stick to the top 10. Done. We don't need anything else. It's a good start because it can only get better. Well, thank you very much, everybody. This has been the first day back for this week of the Biscuit Streams. Of course, tomorrow is Guest Wednesday, but it depends on how hard all the development team are working. But I'm sure I'll be able to grab a guest from somewhere to come on and help me review a biscuit from Frontier Developments tomorrow. So do stick around tomorrow for Guest Wednesday. We're doing lots more jumping tomorrow. I am making some progress. And once I get to the Rock'n'Vaux Crossing, or however you pronounce it, then it's home straight from there. Like, actually, just you can actually just head straight and go to Sagittarius A. We're, of course, going to be going by Millstone Barn's ringed Earth-like planet as well to go and give that a quick scan and steal some credits from there, which would be great. I might get Zach in. That's a nice idea. The kind of biscuit that's been in your granny's biscuit barrel for a few years, and they taste just like that too. It's just so disappointing. I thought foxes were good. People are betrayed. People are feeling betrayed. But yeah, good on you all. You're all brilliant. This week can only get better. Because the party rings was a bad start, but I love the irony of the party ring. So it wins extra points for me because the irony is it's got nothing in it as well. It's like 117 calories, 28 calories, 1%. You have to eat 100 of these to get your daily calorie intake. Just what a load of nonsense. All right, look out for Robert Smith. All right, thank you everybody, you've been wonderful, and as per usual, thank you so much more of this nonsense tomorrow. So yeah, see you soon. Bye. Thank you. Bye. Bye, 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 bye. Edward Lewis would like to apologise for the changed music. He just wanted to try something different, and he regrets it deeply. Have a lovely day, everybody. Don't eat party rings. Bye. I wasn't apologising to you, I was apologising to me. I don't like this music as much as the last one, so we're going straight back to it. Goodbye again.